Hey everyone, my name is Duke, and this is the world premiere of The Binding of Isaac Rebirth. The game just launched. I just set up my options. I'm going ahead and sync the chat. I was streaming some Ali Ali earlier, waiting for the game to unlock, but that probably won't be archived or anything. Alright, so we have attack, which I mapped to the four face buttons. Bomb is on my controller's left bumper, or L1 rather. Alright. Alright, and right off the bat, this is very different than any room you would see in the basement in the Binding of Isaac normally. Alright, it looks like there's a bomb in that block, so let's go on ahead and bomb that and see if I get anything else. Oh. Oh, okay. So, that's not a bomb you can collect, that's just a bomb that blows up. Alright, so, I have an actual, like... Okay, so the map button just, like... brings it up, but makes it opaque, or a little translucent, I guess. That's interesting. Right, so feeling pretty good about the controllers so far. I mean, of course it's going to take a little getting used to. Bombs are key, so I just swapped my one key for one bomb instead. Okay. Who's this? Who are you, sir? Oh, okay. I guess it was just a dude. Hey! Looked like he was some sort of mini-boss or something. Gotta say, this looks great. I really like the updated look of this game. I know some people were complaining about it, but I think it is... I think it's perfect. A lot of giblets coming out of the enemies when you kill them now. Nice touch. Can I shoot these pots? Can I do anything with these? Or are they just decoration? Maybe there's something in them if I blow them up. I'm not sure. I kind of want to hold on to my bombs for now. Alright, so I don't want to go to the boss room yet. If I get really low on health, I might use a bomb to get those. But I wonder if the secret room setup is the same as it was in The Binding of Isaac plus Wrath of the Lamb. Like, I wonder if there are still two secret rooms on every floor. Chet. I didn't see anything about, like, co-op or the level editor or anything like that in the menu. I might want to go back and take a look at that after I'm done with this run. Okay, so this is one of the bigger rooms I was talking about. Yeah, so the level layout is now way more complex than it was in Vanilla Binding of Isaac. Like, the rooms, you know, you can have multiple exits on each wall. You know, the rooms can be differently shaped, they can be larger than normal, they can be smaller than normal. So yeah, really, really excited about seeing what all this game has to offer. Golden Touch. Okay. So, if I were to guess, I would say that means when I touch enemies, they drop money now. But I don't want to touch an enemy to test it out. Alright, well, let's have two bombs. Hey! Good guess, Duke. Let me bring my chat window back up here. Okay. Lost it when I was setting everything up. Maybe co-op will be an update. Yeah, maybe. Not sure. Wait, what was that? Oops, shit. Is that a password? Y9ZZP0VY? Because that would be pretty interesting if there's like a quick save or something. And you have to put the password in to resume your game. Does it change? No? Still the same. Right. But I want to get those hearts. I should probably go ahead and get them. I don't know if I can get both of those with one bomb, but let's try. Yep, there we go. Oh, dungeon seed. Yeah, that's probably it, Quack Party. I don't know, it doesn't seem like enough letters to really, cover all the necessary information for a dungeon seed. Well, I have all this money, so let's see what's in the shop. Right. Donation. I wonder if that's similar to the beggar. Well, I don't know what this item is. If I had enough money, I would buy it just to find out. Oh, it is the level seed. Huh. I guess there's not as much information as I thought. Yeah, that's true. I saw that video after all was talking about where Edmund McMillan was playing co-op with his wife. But yeah, it's definitely a thing. Maybe it's something you have to unlock by beating the game or something like that. That'd be kind of weird. So smooth, no slowdown at all, even with all these flies on the screen. Alright, Duke. You should know better than to take on a fellow Duke. Nice. Health up. Grab that heart. Don't need that one. And success. (36 to the power of 8) is over 2 trillion. Yeah, I guess that's true. 26 letters plus 10 numbers. Yeah, okay. Your math checks out. So I guess this is one of those challenge rooms that I can only enter if I only have one health. Damn, these flies are fast. They're like forming an attack formation. That's cool. New kind of fly. I bet these guys are going to explode. You know, nope. They just die. Alright. Might want to, because there's a gray block there, two above me. I'm gonna. Oh, wait, I'm out of bombs. Dang it. Is there a way to enter your own seed? Well, I know there's like a level editor or something where there's supposed to be, so I'm assuming that there's some way to play other people's levels. I'm not sure if you do that by entering in a seed, or if you download them, or what's going on. So there's another gray block there, but still no bombs, so let's go see if I can find some. Dang, that's a lot of flies. I have a lot of room to dodge around them now, though. Still not quite sure how I feel about the controller. I mean, I'm doing okay with it, but, I don't know. Feels a little weird. I wish there was a way I can collect those bombs that I see in the blocks. Be happy to just take those. Oh yeah, it could be a separate tool, says Bippo. Yeah, after this run I will definitely go in and explore the menu and stuff a little bit more, see if there's any more information. But I wanted to just, you know, jump into a run here. Hello, Kutef. Thanks for hanging out. I mean, it might be the lemonade, but it looks more off-white than yellow. Not sure what that is. Pick it up. Soy milk. Damage down, but tears way up. Holy shit. Well. It's similar to the number one item. It reduces your damage, but it increases your tier output. Only this is like way, way more tiers. Oh shit. Oh wait, those are mine. Okay, cool. I thought those belonged to the enemy. The Fool. Oh, that takes you back to the start, so I probably don't want to do that right now. Damn it, I have all these coins, but no money and no keys. Yeah, okay, so I can take a point of damage to get in here, and then I can just use the Fool to teleport out if I don't take another one. Hopefully, damn, it's dark in here. I like this item. Man, if I get some damage up power-ups, this is going to be insane. Oh, great. Thanks. Thanks for the bomb, game. I appreciate it. Oh, if I take one more point of damage, I can do the challenge room. But, yeah, not much else I can do right now. Yeah, it's like a tier machine gun. I can't shoot these bomb rocks, can I? Doesn't look like it. There aren't any that are, like, accessible to me. Alright, well, let's go fight a boss. Definitely can't do anything with these. Okay, can't go to the item shop. Alright, where was the boss? Okay, so yeah, that just, that brings the map up. Makes it more visible. Also shows you your time, which is interesting. I wonder if there are any mechanics where the amount of time you've been playing comes into play. Like the Spelunky Ghost or anything. Really like the sound effect on this machine gun as well. Very satisfying. Splat, 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 splat. Damn it! I don't think I've touched an enemy yet, so I'm not sure. Not sure if my, wait, maybe that's an activated item. I just didn't think to use it. But it doesn't have, like, a slot on my screen or anything. Yeah, the item activation button didn't do anything. Maybe this would play better with the sticks. I don't know. My thumb is starting to hurt a bit. Alright, I got a monstrous tooth. That's like in ears plus shot speed up. Dang. Alright, no bombs or keys still. Kind of a bummer. Yeah, toothpicks were an item from the previous game as well. And there are like three of these gray blocks on this level. I don't have access to any of them. Alright, well. Let's head to the caves. Really like that pixelized fade in and fade out effect. It's really cool. It reminds me of like old SNES games used to do that a ton. Like Mario World. Hey, stay away from me. Stay away from me, you. I wonder if there's any kind of, like, in-game item explanation in this version. But it would be nice if I didn't have to go to the Binding of Isaac wiki every time I want to know what a new item does. Man, I can just decimate these poops. I don't know what these things are. They're, like, living poops. They make a pretty adorable squeaking noise when they attack. And they're just pretty adorable overall. Most adorable poop ever. Alright, nothing special, though. So. Pick a door. So yeah, I touched one of those spiders and nothing happened. It didn't turn into gold or anything. So yeah, I have no idea what Midas has touched us. Dang. They just have all kinds of tricks up their sleeve. Stuff does take a while to die with this machine gun tears, though. What was this item called? Soy milk. That's right. Hey, bombs and keys. How about that? Oh yeah, the Mask of Infinity Majin Paul. That is one of my least favorite bosses. Alright, well, let's head in this direction since I didn't really explore that much. Whoa! Shit! Oh god. Running dangerously low on health. What's up? Petrified poop. It feels lucky. Oh, okay. Well, if you say so. Shit. Well, maybe it makes hearts drop more often or something, now that I'm lucky. Hey, there's a petrified poop down in the port. Oh wait, that's probably just my items. It's not actually on the screen. Yeah. That makes more sense. I remember you. You're no less annoying now. Shit. I'm definitely not getting any no damage achievements for this run. LOL. I mean, next time for sure, right guys? Teleporter? Oh, doctor's remote. Interesting. Oh, okay, so that green bar, I guess, is the recharge meter. But is that the item shop? I can't tell what the icon is. Oimo seems like a bad item by itself. Eh, I guess it's kind of a wash, really. I'm probably not killing stuff any slower than I would with just normal tears. Okay, so yeah, that is the item shop, I guess. Alright, this thing... It's either Mom's pill bag, or it's the thing that lets me hold an extra trinket. But I don't even have one trinket yet. I could use some health. Well, I have 23 coins, so... I should just hang on to it, really, because I'm going to want to unlock Kane. Petrified poop makes poop drop more items. Yeah, that makes sense, because it looked like the poop was all dropping stuff after I picked it up. Gross, it's like a Siamese maggot. I mean, a conjoined maggot. That is the preferred nomenclature. Man, this music is so good. Alright, I need to test this doctor's remote, but I'm a little afraid because I always end up killing myself with it. Well, you know, let's test it on something that can't fight back. Okay. So you can't control it with the D-pad. Well, that didn't work the way I was hoping. Might be a mouse-only item now. That is a lot of money. Holy crap. I like how putting out these fires actually affects the level of the lighting in the room. That's really cool. We're taking 2 damage to get all that. Not at the moment. Not at my current level of health. Yeah, I see where you're coming from after all. It is a little frustrating. But, you know, hopefully I'll get some items that will beef it up a little bit. Damn it. Oh, crap. All these new monsters that I don't know how they work. I should probably go back and buy that health. And pick up some of this health. Hate to use my 2 bombs getting this stuff, but I'm going to need it. I should probably focus on just beating the game before I start worrying about unlocking characters, having a successful run. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and get that. Okay. So yeah, that one is more trinket rune. Oh, I should have used my doctor's remote again. It charged already. I thought it would take longer than that to charge. Polyphemus is a pain on its own. Yeah, that's true. Completely empty room? Okay. Alright, I'm going to test for secret doors with the doctor's remote and also see if I can figure out how it works. Alright, so it's not the mouse cursor. Oh, I bet... Okay, I'm dumb. I bet I just have to use the shoot buttons to control it. Yeah, mouse doesn't appear to do anything in this version of the game. Which, I mean, I never used it except for the doctor's remote, so it's not a huge deal or anything. Oh, hey, it's Shub. I like this guy. He's pretty easy. God, even these maggots take quite a few hits to kill. You know what would be awesome with this weapon is the coal. Because every single one of these shots would do more damage at an increased distance. Okay, so that guy actually turned to gold, but I didn't get any money from him or anything. Maybe if I kill him before he changes back, I get money for it. Or more money than normal or something. I guess it's just a percentage chance kind of thing. Shit. Alright, so he dropped a penny, but... Yeah. Shit. Oh, hey. Where's some bosses, too? That's interesting. Shit. God, stay away from me. Yeah, my stats are not great at the moment. My speed and my damage are both horrible. And I don't know if having this many shots makes up for the reduced damage. Okay, so that guy dropped 3 coins. So yeah, the Midas touch does make enemies drop a little bit of money. Range up. Okay, I'll take it. Mouse plus gamepad sounds terrific. Well, yeah, obviously, you know, you would use the mouse and keyboard, but yeah, mouse and gamepad would never work. Alright, well that was rough, but I'm still alive. Oh, I have an arcade. I want to spend my money. I guess I might as well. Oh, arcade looks exactly the same. Nice, that paid off. God, look how long it takes just to kill a fly. Paralysis. I'm glad I picked that up, or I'm glad I used that when there were no enemies around. Alright, well that was a pretty fruitful arcade. Got a couple keys, got a couple bombs. I don't like these skeleton guys. Do not like them one bit. Probably just because I'm not used to them. Once I get used to their attack patterns and all that. Oh god. A mobile version of these guys? That's annoying. I mean, who saw this enemy and thought, you know what would make these enemies better? They can move around. I wonder if they're still unbombable. Except when they're open. Test. Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, it did the little animation that it does when you try to bomb it when it's closed. So yeah, same bomb mechanics. Ow! You asshole! God, I need to stop getting hit in every single room. To say, I'm not sure if I would take the soy milk again if it were to come up in another run. I mean, unless I had like a trinket or something that increased my weapon damage. Speaking of trinkets, I haven't seen a single one so far. It's kind of unfortunate considering I bought Mom's coin purse. Oh, these guys. I know how to deal with you. Oh, you make an awesome new noise, I see. Alright. Man, that is really hard to control with the face buttons. Might work better if I was using like a dual joystick kind of setup. Dual analog stick. Or maybe I'll just go back to using keyboard when I play the game solo and just deal with the gamepad just when I play co-op. God, would you die already? How many times do I have to hit you? Stop regenerating. I can't hit these things enough times before they regenerate. Good God. Finally. Yeah, I mean, if I found something that I know combos with the soy milk, I'd pick it up then, but, hasn't happened yet. Of course, you know, I just started playing, so I guess I shouldn't jump to those kinds of conclusions. Best weapon ever. Yeah, no kidding, Bippo. Especially against these guys. I mean, look at this bullshit. Boy, Joker, eh? I will use that immediately. Oh, this guy. Well, getting any of these would kill me. Because it takes full hearts first, right? Before it takes empty hearts. I get exactly how that works, actually. Well, I don't want to give up any hearts anyway. Something that increases my damage a whole bunch. Concussive tears. That sounds like it might be good. Oh, my damage is still one. Maybe it's like a knockback effect or something. I agree, after all. Angel rooms for the win. Man, the PhD is on sale, and I can't afford it. Alright, we get the battery. I don't really want this item to charge faster, though. I don't care that much about it. Let's see what the donation thing does. Or I could buy a pill. If it's a bad trip pill, since I only have half a heart left, it would turn into a full heal pill. So, that's like a 2 in whatever chance of getting a full heal instead of just 1. Worth a shot. Luck up. Separate stat for luck? Oh yeah, there is. It's like a little clover thing. Congrats, Jistrot. Good luck. And I guess I'll donate my last one. Because why not? Well, more luck is theoretically good, but I'm still sitting at half a hit point. Okay, so they have like a little daze effect. Not sure what that does. Doesn't seem to slow them down at all. Oh, I guess it just like confuses them maybe? Yeah, because they're just running around randomly instead of coming towards me. That's kind of cool. With the soy milk, that's many, many more chances of that effect actually happening because there are so many projectiles. Yeah, same Agak. I have no idea what would happen if I tried to deal with the devil. So better not to worry about it. Alright. Probably see what's over in this area before I go into the big room. Kind of making my way around this dungeon willy-nilly. No! No! Bad enemies! Ah, shit. Inaugural death. How do I, Right, I want to go back to the main menu. And recognize gamepad. Yeah. Right, so I can continue my game. Oh, okay. So it is like a quick save when you exit. That's awesome. That is a very good feature. Okay, new run. Oh, there's a hard mode? My win streak is -1. Great. Press tab to input a seed. So yeah, I could play the level I just did. If I wanted to. Or I could play any other seed. Yeah, I'm not seeing any kind of co-op option. Maybe if I plugged in another controller, it would come up. But you should be able to play with a controller and a keyboard, shouldn't you? Yeah, there's no, like, co-op option here. I don't know. Alright, well, let's continue this run I just started because there's an item room right here. Little brimstone. Oh, I see. The brimstone effect in a familiar. A fancy seed name like Duke Duke. Yeah, see what comes up. I bet there are like secret codes you can put in to get like special joke levels or something. Wow. That's going to be tricky to use, but when I use it, it seems pretty effective. A seed just dropped, yeah. Well, I'm already liking this better than the soy milk. Oh yeah, I put in time fuck. I spell it like that. Or secret event. Or maybe meat boys. Meat boys? I don't know. Alright, should I use my bomb looking for secrets? Probably not, but I will anyway. Oh, you're playing hard mode just dropped? Jeez. You are more hardcore than I, sir. Alright, Gemini. See how you feel about Lil Brimstone. I like it. That was me speaking, not Gemini. Gemini doesn't like it. Gemini has other ideas about what a good time is. Alright, health up. I'll take it. No bombs, no keys. Anything else on this map? Well, an item shop I can't get into. Alright. Yeah, it seems to do just as much damage as the actual brimstone power-up. It's just a little trickier to use. For stationary enemies, though, it's awesome. Because you can just do this. Battery? Wait. Why no give me battery? Oh, that must just be like a pickup, and if I had an item, it would probably charge it instantly. I bet that's what that's for. It's not the same battery as the item from the normal Binding of Isaac. Right, oh, there's an arcade here. I think I'll hold on to my pennies for now. Aw, brimstone doesn't destroy the fire, that sucks. I mean, I think if you launched a stream of blood at a fire would probably go out. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, Quack Party. Like, it either adds some charge to an item or it charges an item fully. Damn it! Oh hey, when I got hit, it triggered the brimstone. That's kind of cool. Well, no basement boy achievement for me. I think that was the first time I've been hit. It's kind of like how you get hearts even if you have full health, Quack Party. It's just a, just a pickup. Alright, let's check out the rest of this level before I hit the boss. Alright, there's a room over here I didn't go in. I should probably go into the arcade just to see if I can get a key. Because getting to the item room would be pretty... Oh wait, that's just the item shop. Okay. So yeah, let's see if I can get a key. Well, this is a different arcade. Oh wait, so has my donation from last time. Oh! I bet that's what that unlockable thing on the main screen was. Once you donate enough gold over the course of multiple games, it probably unlocks stuff. Alright, well, no way to get a key in that room. So I will hold on to my pennies for now. Wait, what is this? Oh yeah, that's right. This is one of those. Take damage and hope it gives me a chest room. So I wonder if it's better in this than it was in the main game. Not really. Hoping it would give me a normal chest that might have a key in it. Or two. Good item. And more HP up. Which is good. It's not a key though. Yeah, burning blood would probably smell horrible. But luckily I don't have a smell-o-vision. So I wouldn't have to deal with it. Hey, stop spawning spiders. Real dick move, guy. Nice. Crack the sky. Okay, cool. That's the thing that makes light rain down and hurt enemies. Yeah, I agree, Quack Party. I should be way better off with little brimstone than I was with the soy milk. Well, that did nothing. God, their faces are melting. It's disturbing. Yep, definitely feels good to be doing some damage, Pippa. Anything special I can do with these, or do I just have to bomb them? Probably just have to bomb them. Oh, like they exploded in a poisonous cloud. Well, I'm glad I moved away. Pretty fly, nice. Liberty cap. Touch fuzzy, get dizzy. It's funny because someone just referenced that like half an hour ago during the Ollie Ollie stream. It's better than the real item. Yeah, kind of after all. I mean, it is a little like. Lining it up is a little trickier, but still having, you know, your normal tiers as well is definitely a good trade-off for that. Jesus Christ. Room is terrible. Ah. timing it to hit those guys with the brimstone is going to be next to impossible. I'm just going to have to get lucky. I mean, I still think going with using the brimstone would be better than just trying to shoot these guys, though. I don't know. Stop shooting, please. Please stop shooting. I killed everything. Why are you still shooting? Will you stop shooting if I leave and come back? Oh my god, really? I mean, the thing about brimstone is you never find it just sitting around in an item room. So, that alone is a good thing about little brimstone. Right, got the item room. And go back and hit- oh wait, there's a library over there. Maybe I should go there. No, I should go to the item shop and try to buy some health. I like Crack the Sky, it's a good item to have. I mean, if I had a guaranteed Book of Revelation sitting in the library, then I'd go for that. Buy the pill, or try to find another penny and buy whatever that thing is. Very ugly fly. Wait, what's this red room up here? Oh, it's one of those. That's right. Well, I used my only key, so there's no getting back into the library. Alright, well, let's fight the boss. And if I don't get another coin, I will, I'll buy that pill. If I don't die. Gurry Jr. Can't talk. Oh god. Thank you for the health, Mr. Gurdy Jr., sir. Latchkey, luck up. Oh, interesting. Alright, devil. Got for me. Oh. Well, this is different. Am I going to have to spend hearts to open these? It doesn't have the symbol, so I'm assuming not. Oh wow. Well, that was very nice of you, Mr. Devil, sir. You're way nicer than that last devil in that old game. Alright, well, that paid off. So let's go see what's in the library. And then I guess go buy that pill since I didn't find another penny. Oh! Tarot cards. Temperance. Okay. Well, I can get a penny that way. A devil. Okay. A hanged man. A magician. Okay. These are all familiar tarot cards. Hang on to the devil. Give you one thing. One piece of heart. Gertie is a lady. Oh, it is? If it's a lady, then why is it Junior? Ladies don't usually have juniors, do they? Yes, exactly. Like Afferall says, Gertie is a thing. Giant spiders and flies. Oh. I guess that means the ones I fight will be giants, so they'll be easier to hit. Not sure if that's a good thing or not. Alright, let's look for a secret room. I can't tell where the, like the middle. I guess it's like right here. Nope. Okay. Oh, worth a shot. Really sucks that those things don't stop when you clear the room. Ladies don't normally have giant colons attached to them. Good point. Oh, Jesus Christ. That thing exploded so big. I think it blew something else up and caused a chain reaction. That's why the explosion seemed big. I'm not sure if that was the giant version of the normal spider, or if that was just a different kind of enemy. Junior is a junior gender neutral term. Yeah, but you don't usually see ladies with junior after their name. Missing page. So what that does is every once in a while when I get hit, it'll do the Necronomicon effect, I believe. If it's the same as in the last game, which I'm assuming it is. Junioris or Juniorette? I don't think so. Never really heard that. Hey guys. Wait, what's a star? Oh, that must be, that's the trinket, okay. Well, I don't have any money to give you, and I don't really want to give you any hearts. Hey, Galen. What word would we see? Oh, instead of junior, you mean? I don't know. I mean, normally, like, giving the child the same name as the parent is just like a patriarchal thing. It's like something that men do with their sons. You don't normally see women naming daughters after themselves. I mean, I'm sure it happens. But, at least in the U.S., I don't know how it is in the rest of the world. I know that in Iceland, like, patriarchal naming is totally the norm. Because, like, Björk, the singer, her last name is, like, Goodman's daughter or something like that. So, the poop? What if I don't want poop? I think I'll keep my Crack the Sky. Any tells for the secret rooms? Oh, you mean like how they're always bordered by a certain number of rooms? I'm not sure. I mean, I've sort of been going with the same secret room strategy that I did with the old Binding of Isaac, but I'm not sure if that would still apply. You know, bombing where they're bordered by a lot of rooms. Alright, well, no point going to the item shop. Bunch of rooms over there I haven't gone in yet. Okay, I'll give you a coin. Nothing. Fair enough. Well, let's see. Two bombs and a key, but I'd have to take... basically lose a soul heart. I think that's worth it. Well, lose two soul hearts because it did a whole heart of damage instead of just half. Oh, super fast because of the mushroom effect. Oh god! Oh, Jesus Christ. I was not expecting these guys to have that pattern of shots. I totally got caught in the crossfire there. I don't even want to ask what this thing is. I'm sure whatever it is, I'm better off not knowing. Oh, thanks for standing still, guys. I appreciate it. Ooh. That was a good chest. Might want to go to the item shop now. Oh yeah, women are expected to change their last names when they marry. Yeah, that's that would explain why you don't see it that often. Alright, anything else? Just the item shop and the boss. I have 4 keys, so probably. Well, I guess I could give all my money to the beggar. Yeah, I'll check out the item shop. Well, it was bound to happen sooner or later. Very nice. I am very happy with my little brimstone. Thanks, Majin Paul. I appreciate it. Mega fatty. This guy a new thing, or is he a new version of an old thing? Looks like a new thing. Oh, Jesus Christ. That is a new thing. Oh my God. That is disgusting. Chubby. Okay. Range up. Pull up on hearts. Nice. Oh, I keep forgetting about my crack the sky. I need to remember to use those. The bone throwers. Yeah, just drop. They are annoying. All right. I have 6 bombs, but I have no idea where I should be bombing to look for secret rooms. With the weird new level layouts and stuff. It's not always immediately obvious, which is good. Peter Griffin, yeah. All right, made it to the depths. Why are these guys so tiny? See, this guy stops shooting when the room's clear. He knows his place. What are these? Just another bombable, I guess? You suck. Shit. though. Worth using a bomb and a key to get that, I guess. Especially since it just gave me another bomb. I don't think it's bashing religion after all. I think it's bashing, like, the crazy fundamentalist types. I don't think it has anything against religion itself. It's an interesting room. I mean, there has to be something good over here, right? Well, there's another bond to replace the one I just used, so... I mean, it uses religious imagery in a positive way, as well as a negative way. I mean, you have the angel rooms, and you have, like, the halo and stuff. You know, good items that come from religion. Best bud. I guess that's just a new kind of fly orbital. I don't know if there's anything special about it. Giant poop. Slow down in the game so far? Nope. None. At least I haven't noticed any. Oh, shit. Oh, it spawns the thing when I get hit. Okay. That's interesting. Reusable fly hide. I need to start remembering to use my damn items. Well, at least with this one, I can just kind of trigger it whenever, and, you know, I can just trigger it as soon as it charges. I don't have to remember to use it, you know, at the right moment. Oh, hey, it recharges after one room? That's right. I remember that now. Hey, CPC Gamer. Man, remember how much trouble I just had with these guys? Oh, how laughable. Oh shit, wrong button. I'm gonna have to get used to my new buttons. Oh, Jesus Christ. Nice. Plenty of bombs now. Tower. Oh yeah, I totally forgot I had the devil. I'll hang on to it. And still. Jeez. Alright, I have one key, but I have plenty of money, so worth checking this out. It looks like the fetus jar, but there's no fetus in it. What you do? Save your life. Okay. Oh, bet I can like put hearts into it or something. And then use it to get health back. That's my guess anyway. I have to wait and pick up some hearts and see what happens. Yeah, it doesn't have a meter beside it, so I don't think it's a rechargeable item. Right, one room down there that passed up, so go back and see what's up. so now that I'm full up on hearts, the next time I get a heart, I can test my theory. Well, unless I hit damage, of course. Yours up, nice. I wonder if that means my brimstone charges faster now. I think there's some sort of relationship between your tier stat and the brimstone. Not 100% sure what it is though. Hero card I can get to. Anything else I want to do here? Well, there's some hearts up here. Let me go see if they're accessible. Oh, right. I have to go back through this area. I mean, even if they're not accessible, I have 11 bombs, so... Yep, it went into the jar. And it says times one. So I'm assuming I can store more than one in there. That is really cool. That seems like a good item. The rooms with TNT on them. Not sure. I haven't seen any TNT barrels or anything. Are they on the map? Oh, you mean like this little icon? Like the dynamite? I think that's a tarot card. Because yeah, there's one here as well. That's the tarot card icon. Alright, boss. Wait, which floor is this? This is still the depths one, right? I think so. Yeah. So no mom fight yet. That's a good sound effect. When Monstro sprays, uses blood. The sound in this game is all very good, not just the music. Sounds like a dinosaur or something. Not that I actually know what a dinosaur sounds like. Like for realsies. Alright, speedball. Speed plus shot speed. Nice. Some more hearts for my jar. Very cool item. Yeah, Monstro's. He's made out of mode 7. Alright. What kind of room is this? Oh, I guess it requires two keys to get into, and I only have one. Jesus. Oh, wow. Oh my god. Are these things just going to infinitely- okay. Respawn? I'm gonna say I hope not. Hey, fuck you. Puberty. Oh well. Could have been worse. Right into that trail of blood. And you will know us by the trail of blood. Can't lock Monstro 2's pattern. Well, I mean, you probably can. I'm just not, not the best. You bonehead. One hand bomb for that heart. By pressing space. I mean, activating the space doesn't do anything since I'm using the controller. You want me to activate the jar? Because I figure all that's going to do is empty it out and give me those three hearts. And I want to save that for when I'm low on health. Jet. Nope. I was trying to get him to eat one, but he didn't charge. I mean, I don't know. It might just make me use enough hearts to fill me up, and then the rest of the hearts will stay in the jar. But I kind of want to wait until I'm low on health to test it. Still don't have another key. We cannot get in there just yet. Two of these guys. That's gonna be frustrating. I'm gonna have to make sure. Shit. Well, never mind. I'm gonna say take them one at a time. They had other plans. Alright, let's go ahead and use this key here. Wow. That was a good use of that key. Tears up. Joker. Dude, that takes me. Light! Oh, wonderful. I'm flying. I could afford the curse room with all the hearts. Yeah, I don't know. It still doesn't seem worth it most of the time. Wait, do I have the compass? I can see where the item room and the boss and everything is. Oh, it must be an effect from the Liberty Cap. I forgot about that. It's probably one of the best things you can get from the Joker card. Oh yeah, I don't have to worry about the blood now because I'm flying. What the hell? Like, oh, I couldn't hit those floating heads, but they died when the other monsters died. That's okay. I can see forever. I guess that just maybe that reveals the map. No, because I still don't see where the boss room is. Huh. Ooh. That seems satanic. Oh, Virgo. Okay. I feel refreshed and replenished. Don't know what that does. Oh shit, really? Oh hey, secret room opened up. That's cool. Oh, it's this guy. Well, normally I would just back out, but, well, I might end up doing that anyway. I don't know. There might be a Chivo or something for defeating all the super versions of the Sins. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and, pop my hearts. Okay. Oh, so it just, it puts them on the ground. That's cool. So if I want to... Oh, I bet I Can See Forever just reveals all the secret doors. Because look, all of the secret doors are open. It's like the X-ray specs. Or the miner's helmet. I can never remember which is which. Yeah, when I leave and come back, the secret room is still open. That's really awesome. Jesus died for my chivos. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's in the Bible somewhere. What the? Oh, I used my double card. I hit the bumper by mistake. Well, I don't have a key, so I can't get into the item shop anyway. I just want to say, I want to save my money since I'm so close to unlocking the game. Oh yeah, I can just kill these guys the old-fashioned way now. Okay. I'll use that again, I guess. Right, anything I'm missing? The curse room. Oh wait. Okay, that's just the item room. I mean, there might be another secret. Well, speak of the devil, there's another secret door right here. Oh, I guess 4 is the maximum. And carrying around a jar of 8 hearts would be pretty broken. So yeah, I guess that makes sense. Alright, well, this should be Mom coming up, so hold on to your butts, everyone. Brimstone doesn't seem to be doing that much damage. Come on. Well, I got a shield from something. I'm not sure what effect gave me that shield. Might be part of the Angel Wings effect. Shit. Pop that. My heart jar. Seems more difficult than Mom in the original Binding of Isaac. Seems to be a lot more stuff going on the screen. Seems to be going a lot faster. Shield is definitely helpful though. Wish I knew what was giving that to me. I mean, it's not my trinket, because that's not something...
Was his mother, fueled with the desire to serve her god, was bearing down on Isaac. I will do as I'm told, my lord. I love you above all else, Isaac's mother repeated to herself. This was the end of the line for Isaac. His mother was far too strong for him. But just as he accepted his fate, God intervened, sending an angel down from above to stop his mother's hand. And just like that, it was over.
Yep, there we go. Oh, Virgo was the thing giving me the shield. Yeah, that's possible. I didn't notice it said something about protecting me. I thought it just said, like, refreshed and replenished. Challenge number 20. Horseman. You have meat. Well. Your challenge number 20 is... Oh, purist, okay. That's where you have to play with nothing. Just your tears. Win streak 1. Hell yeah. Man, kind of disappointing that I don't see anything about co-op. I mean, maybe that's something that's going to be added. Not really sure. Alright, well, in the stream on the high note, I guess. I've been going for a couple hours. I've been playing The Binding of Isaac for a couple hours, but I feel like that's a good first look at the game. That's a good taste. I'm definitely enjoying it so far. I think it plays better than the original. And I think I'm getting used to the controller. You know, there's still a ton of items to discover, a ton of new enemies and bosses to discover. So, yeah. I'm looking forward to streaming this a whole lot more in the coming days. So, thanks for watching, everyone. See you later.